There was a time when there were just plans and speculation about starting a colony on Mars. And now, by the looks of things, it might actually happen, all thanks to Elon Musk. He has always had the ambition of building a mighty spacecraft that will be used to transport people to Mars and start a colony. The mighty spacecraft, the Starship, will be used to transport those willing to relocate to Mars from Earth. However, this is not a small distance, and it would take months in space before they landed on Mars. Because of this, Musk and his company SpaceX have to find a way to shield the travellers from the effects of microgravity during the whole journey. This led SpaceX to develop an artificial gravity starship. But what is this special starcraft and how does it work? Join us as we explore this spacecraft and learn more about it. Remember to leave a like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications on later videos. And with that said, let's dive into it. For those of you who think that attempting to go to Mars is impossible, then Elon Musk might just be the one to prove all of you wrong. The Starship is inspired by Musk's vision of starting a colony on Mars and transporting people there to live permanently. It is promised to be the most powerful spacecraft ever built. It will be configurable to transport either humans or cargo. It is a very unique space rocket in several aspects. For example, it is capable of carrying at least 100 tons into orbit. This is very important because it can transport lots of tons of cargo to Mars ahead of the people. There is a lot of cargo that needs to be delivered even before people can start moving there. Since Mars has a very harsh environment, Musk has to provide systems that will help the colonizers adapt to their life there. He also needs to supply food, water, construction materials for building, and a lot of machinery for making rocket fuel. This is just some of the materials that are required to be transported. If we gave you the full list, we might as well give you a whole hour of just naming the materials. Starship is said to have two stages, the upper and lower stage. After these two stages separate, the lower stage, known as the Super Heavy Booster, returns to Earth while the upper part, or the ship, proceeds towards Mars. Both stages are completely reusable, hence saving on the cost of building more. Once the Super Heavy Booster returns to Earth, it is quickly serviced and prepared for the next flight. For propulsion, Starship depends on about 30 Raptor engines, which are designed and developed by SpaceX. For the upper stage, it is covered with heat-resistant tiles, which protect it from any sort of damage from the heat while re-entering the Earth after each mission. Musk plans to have at least 1 million people on Mars. Because of this, SpaceX plans to produce about 1,000 of these starships. In addition to that, he plans to launch at least 3 starships per day. In addition to transporting people to Mars, NASA also plans to use the Starship for its next mission to the Moon. It is expected to take the astronauts onto the Moon's surface and bring them back to Earth after they complete their missions. For the cargo carrier, the Starship is quite easy to design and it does not need a lot of equipment inside. However, when you start bringing people into the equation, then it becomes a little more complicated to design. For shorter trips, like to the Moon, SpaceX does not have a lot of worries, simply because the journey would only last for several days. However, for transporting people to Mars, the journey would take months. This in turn exposes the passengers on board to harmful radiation, since the Starship is expected to pass through some harsh environments before landing on Mars. Therefore, SpaceX has to build something that protects them from this radiation. This can be easily solved by putting shields all around the Starship. However, this does not solve one of the biggest issues there, the issue of gravity. This has remained the greatest issue when it comes to space travel. Astronauts who are not going as far as Mars have to stick to a very strict routine of exercise while aboard the International Space Station. This is to help them make it through the whole journey. However, it is insufficient because some astronauts who return from month-long missions must be carried on stretchers upon landing. Musk's wish is to achieve the luxury that is seen in some space movies, where people live a normal life on a huge spaceship, and even when they land, they go about their duties without any worries or conditions. However, the reality is not as easy as the movies make it look. If Musk wants to achieve this, then he has to ensure that the starships have some form of gravity. To fully understand the importance of this artificial gravity, Nitza Citron, Chief of NASA's Space Medicine and Healthcare Systems Office in Microgravity, explains the effects of microgravity on the human body. Bone loss occurs at a monthly rate of 1 to 1.5%. This leads to accelerated age-related changes similar to osteoporosis. In addition, there is a decrease in bone density and strength in some skeletal regions, like the pelvis. Most of the loss is reversible upon return to Earth, but prolonged exposure to weightlessness increases the risk of kidney stones and bone fractures. In the lower extremities, the muscles are also impacted, as there is a loss of muscle mass, strength, and endurance. These changes in the muscles, together with the effects of microgravity on connective tissues and the demand of activities on varying intensities, may lead the astronaut to fatigue and possibly get injured. During long missions, exercise is key to ensure the astronauts don't experience these changes in their muscles. They use a cycle ergometer and a treadmill with downward applied pressure to maintain fitness. To ensure that Musk's mission is successful, he must ensure that the passengers arrive on Mars healthy enough to be self-sustaining. If not, then they will perish and his plan will come to a disastrous end. Even though SpaceX is the first company to have to deal with the effects of microgravity in actual rocket development, they are not the first to attempt to solve the problem. Konstantin Zilkowski, considered one of the founding fathers of rocketry and astronautics, had a concept. In his study, Investigation of Outer Space Rocket Devices, he proposed using rotational forces to create artificial gravity in space. Since then, there have been more variations and proposals, such as the von Braun wheel or O'Neill cylinder and the Stanford torus. Some of them are even being considered for development, such as NASA's Nautilus X space station. However, each of the proposed methods has drawbacks that makes them impractical or not able to work with the Starship. Others have weird shapes, making them impossible to launch. However, one concept that might work well with Starship is the one proposed by Small Stars on YouTube. His concept uses a system of three Starships that move together. The system consists of a payload bay flanked on each side by a passenger starship. The payload bay would have a truss that unfolds to act as the wheel's spokes. Each starship would have to launch separately from Earth, but once linked up, the passenger ships would swivel around to reorientate themselves and use their thrusters to impart momentum on the wheel. Once enough momentum is generated to simulate Earth's normal gravity, 9.8 ms squared or 1g, the passenger ships reorient themselves to face inward towards the hub ship. For the remainder of the journey, those aboard the passenger ship experience the sensation of being pulled down thanks to the centrifugal force created by the rotation of the wheel. According to Small Stars, the gravity-linked starship concept reuses main engines, taps leftover fuel, and avoids impractical space construction spacewalks. The GLS is a hub ship, like the hub of a wheel. The payload bay of the GLS is filled with a truss that robotically folds out and locks into place, serving as the wheel's spokes. Small Star concluded that the system has to remain in a rotational velocity of 31 meters a second if the system is about 100 meters long in radius in order to simulate Earth's gravity. This would produce the feeling of 1G, making three rotations per minute. Small Stars also calculated that this would use very little fuel to start and stop rotation and prepare the starships for landing. The travellers would still have to follow the strict exercise routines, but they would have a higher chance of arriving on Mars in good health. What do you think of these ideas? Do you think SpaceX will manage to produce artificial gravity? Let us know in the comments section below. If you like this video, then make sure to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell icon for more interesting videos. There are plenty more videos for you to watch. Until next time, bye.